centre.
This is K1 rule.
No headbutting, no elbow, no double low, no holding, and no clinch.
Okay.
Check it.
Yes.
You can see the substantial height difference there between Okubo and Miburo. Miburo, the shorter of the two, but what he may lack in height, he makes for in tenacity. Should be a thrilling contest to kick off our prelims here at the K1 World Max. Our pay-per-view main event card just around 4 hours away. It is Rui Okubo in the blue gloves, Kazuki Miburo in the red gloves. Both men in southpaw, orthodox stance, I should say. Good little use of the lead leg there from Okubo. Good outside leg kick from Okubo. Return favour from Miburo. You can sense the sharpness between these two youngsters at the moment. Okubo is the younger of the two, only 19 years old. 22 years old is Kazuki Miburo.
Yeah, the taller of the two, but the younger of the two, Okubo. He's just sizing his opponent up. He's not taking too many risks early on here, despite his youthful age. And as you said, Mike, he holds a win over Yuji Nasukawa, the younger brother of the very famous Tenshin Nasukawa. And that's quite something, because the Nasukawa family produce studs.
These two are certainly delivering on the speed early on. It's almost like watching it fast forward. Good counter left hand there from Okubo. Then the outside leg kick that already read in the lead leg. Top of the calf, bottom of the quads of Kazuki Miburo. Miburo needs to start checking those leg kicks.
Miburo, the evil wolf, he's fought exclusively for Crush in K1. He's on a 3-fight winning streak coming in here today.
Plenty of instructions being barked from the corner of Kazuki Miburo. Fake off the front leg there, Okubo. Good right hand lead, threaded that one through the guard. And it's what Miburo didn't expect. Rarely will you see an orthodox fighter lead with a straight right cross like that, but it worked. Good overhand right there from Miburo.
Solid use of the lead hand and foot from Rui Okubo.
Nice extension lead jab there from Okubo. Double jab Miburo, no right hand for company though. Good body kick from Okubo. Step through knee, jab again. Good overhand right off the back foot though from Miburo.
Miburo's certainly not letting that reach and height difference work against him.
Left hand, quick release, good right hand down the tube again from Okubo. Throws to the ribs, pumps out the jab again. Trying to measure and pull with that lead hand was Miburo. Final 10 seconds of what's been a wonderful opening round. Kick off K1 World Max 2024, the return of K1 World Max. And don't forget, if you haven't yet booked the pay-per-view, do so wherever you are around the world. Our pay-per-view is less than 4 hours away.
Really impressed by the use of the calf kick. They're not overly using it, but Kazuki Miburo popping it in there, just making sure that the taller of the two, Rui Okubo, is not coming in too close and letting that big long jab of his connect. That's exactly what Miburo does not want. Okubo started kickboxing, influenced by his father when he was 6. And his only loss on his record was in June 2023, a split decision loss. So he's on fire right now, still 19. Coming in guns blazing.
Second round set for 3-1 extra round in case of a draw can be allotted. Let's see how Okubo deals with the leg kicks. Nice front kick early on, rose up to the chest of Miburo. front kick again there from Okubo. Needs to get out of this blue corner though, doesn't want to be cut off there by the shorter opponent who can get on the inside and work those hands, does it? Look, took over the top and a gut-munching front kick from Okubo.
Yeah, he's finding himself getting a little bit backed up there. Start to circle now, using the space of the ring more.
The very vocal corner you can hear is out of Rui Okubo right in front of our commentary position. Every time he lands in Thai style, they are clapping, they are cheering, trying to influence the judges a little. Something no doubt you'll hear the corner of Tan Chai do later tonight in the K1 Max Final 16 showdown. The Seoul Thai entrant we'll see later on, Tan Chai. Meanwhile, good use of that lead hand again here from Rui Okubo.
Libero, constant pressure forward. I like the fact that he's staying in the face of Okubo.
Good jab again from Okubo. Got to use that reach. Just so much of it. Good jab again. Needs the right hand for company. The leg kicks underneath. Didn't turn the knuckles on the left hook. There's the right hand over the top from Okubo. Step through knee from the tall fighter.
Some good body shots finding a home there of the taller opponent. Popping them in. His, of course, you know, Okubo, he's still growing. He's still filling out. And if those body shots can connect, it might wear him down.
Out of this K1 rule set, clinching of any sort is not allowed. You cannot clinch either single or double hand in a knee. You can't throw the knees, just no clinching.
Yeah, the emphasis is on pushing your opponent away from you if they're coming in too close into the clinch range. Starting to get a little bit busier now in the boxing range. Shots in the pocket landing from both men.
Step across the outside leg kick from Miburo. Jumping knee, Okubo trying to get it up to the jaw of the shorter man. Counter right hand from Miburo off the leg kick.
We could see him open up with that knee or the jumping knee a little bit more as he finds space for it down the middle.
There should be, with this enormous reach advantage, no way that Okubo allows Miburo on the inside. Threads it upstairs. There's a cut that looks like to the side of the eye, maybe, on Miburo. As we go to the towers at the end of the second round, once again, folks, get the pay-per-view. K1 Max Final 16, also the Cruiserweight World Title. Karimian versus Lusa. It goes down in under 4 hours' time in the USA, Canada, Australia, New Zealand via Triller. In Europe via Fight Plus and worldwide via Stream Ticket. Book the pay-per-view now, under 4 hours away.
Okubo really finding a home for those knees. Very sharp knees of his, finding his way forward, threading them in, landing them just where he wants them. Underneath the rib cage. I think we might see him pluralize those coming into the next round. He knows they're one of his best weapons.
Third and final round inside the Yoyogi Arena in Tokyo, Japan. Crowd continues to fill in. We are expecting a sellout on this public holiday in Japan. It's been a cold few days here. Certainly things starting to heat up. Miburo looking for that right hand, throws the leg kick.
Interestingly, Okubo was the only one that chose to stand up during the interval there.
Beautiful left hand from Miburo. Again, Okubo must use the reach and keep the shorter fighter on the outside. Gets the center in now, does Okubo. Throws a knee, jab, nice front kick to the midsection. They're the type of fluent combination, Stuart, that Okubo needs to use.
Yes. Yeah. Like I was saying, he's still finding a nice home for those sharp knees. He's going to the body with the toe kicks now.
Arms tied up, the overhook there from Miburo. Quick glance to the corner from Okubo. He's got three trainers in his corner, and they've each been as vocal as the other. Nice front kick again from Okubo. That's the lengthy technique you want to see from Rui Okubo.
Yeah, and a nice contact right cross there as well. You know, he's using those long punches, but he's also striking very compact and hard inside the pocket.
In addition to that cut by the side of the left eye, Mibura, there's some blood starting to come out of the nose now of Mibura, I should say. Here's in the red gloves, Okubo in the blue. Good right hand lead again there from Okubo.
Referee very quick to step in there and break up any kind of clinch action. Keep it moving on.
Trying to scorch the nose on that left hand, did Mibura. And again. No jump from Okubo. Won't score for him under these K1 rules. If it was a Muay Thai fight, it certainly would. You can tell that he does have some Muay Thai background, Okubo. Knees again coming into play, getting a little messy in the final minute here of the third and final round.
Yeah, solid, sharp knees there. It doesn't seem to be phasing Mibura at all, though. The Evil Wolf is constantly pressing forward and trying to get in the face of Okubo.
We've got our first contender for moniker of the night, Stuart Evil Wolf. I like it. There's going to be a lot of contenders, though, tonight. A lot of great nicknames coming up as we go on today's show.
There certainly is, and often new monikers get buffed in the K1 ring.
Overhooking that arm again, Mibura. Right hand flashing from Okubo. Mibura trying to create some distance. Okubo wants the knees in the corner of floors as he drills one in the midsection. Front kick to right hand from Okubo.
Okubo constantly busy with those knees, but Mibura completely unalarmed.
Continues to come forward and wait for the attacks of Rui Okubo. Does Kazuki Mibura. There he goes again. Two punch combination. Okubo dances out of the way. Three rounds down. We are going to the judges in our opening prelim. Okubo wasting no time, Stuart. He was standing in center ring waiting for the decision. Mibura's taking a quick seat and now we'll get that decision.
This is what I was saying. He stood up during the intervals.
Okubo.
30-29 Okubo.
Okubo.
He's got it. Rui Okubo. Thanks for win
Okubo
over Kazuki Mibura to kick off our prelims inside Yoyogi Arena here in Tokyo. Once again, folks, our pay-per-view, the K1 Max Final 16. Also, Cena Caribbean versus Lusar for the Cruiserweight World title. That, a bad blood grudge match. And Antonio Prifty of Greece defends the women's flyweight title against the Georgian Sahor of Japan. Book it now via Triller in the USA, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, Fight Plus throughout Europe, and also Stream Ticket Worldwide. It's the K1 Max 2024 pay-per-view.
プレゼントの野口彩子様、ありがとうございました。先週退場